so difficult for you to start. I mean, it's so basic. If you don't go, there's no point in having you.
Mr. Fawlty, telephone.
What?
Telephone.
Where's Sybil?
Okay? Where's the bill?
No, not Bill. I own the place. I don't pay bills. Where's my wife?
She's not here.
She is there.
Never mind. Right, leave it to me. I'll do it. I'll mend the car. I'll answer the telephone. You can change it.
In here. Yes, I know it's...
This way. Yes, I know it's this way. I own the place.
Hello, Fawlty Cares. Oh, Andre, thank you for calling. Kurt's marvellous. We're absolutely delighted with him. Really, Andre, he's wonderful.
This Basil's wife. This Basil. This smack on head.
Yes, dear?
Have you taken the car in yet?
Yes, I'm just dealing with it, dear.
You're not trying to do it yourself, are you, Basil?
Oh, have you seen Miss Mark up here, dear?
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, I did, dear. It's a bit of a scratch.
Take it into the garage, Basil.
Yes, just having a look at it, dear.
Sorry, Andre, where was I? Oh, yes, well, he's the best chef we've ever had. We can't thank you enough for finding him for us. Look, can you come and have dinner on Sunday? There's something we want to ask your advice about. Okay, lovely. See you then.
Hello, Polly. Can you come and have a drink, Mrs. Fawlty?
Drink?
I've just sold a sketch.
Really? I'd love to.
Hello. Kurt, Andre can come on Sunday. I thought you'd taken the car in.
Hmm?
Are you at those again?
I just took one, dear.
I think you've had enough of those, Basil. Now, will you deal with the car, please?
Good, Mr. Fawlty.
Superb, Kurt.
For you, Mr. Fawlty?
Oh, thank you, Polly.
Are you going to do the car?
In a moment, my little piranha fish.
I've just sold a sketch.
What, for money?
I bought it, Mr. Fawlty. She's very talented. Oh, no, Polly,
I won't. Oh, come on.
No, thank you.
Oh, please, I bought it to thank you.
No, honestly.
Don't you like it?
Too much, but not when I'm working. You drink it for me, Manuel.
Well, cheerio.
Cheerio, Basil.
Well, that smells nice.
Here it is, Mr. Fawlty. She's really got something, you know.
Really?
Well, worth 50p, anyway.
Yes, do you win a bun if you guess what it is or something?
It's Manuel.
What?
It's me.
Where?
Manuel is my friend. We are good friends, eh?
Oh, si. Yeah, it's very modern, very socialist. Yeah, something to remember him by, you know, when he goes.
Are you still here, Basil?
No, I went a couple of minutes ago, dear, but I expect I'll be back shortly.
No, Manuel. Look, like this.
Oh, I like that. Will you do me one?
Really? Of Manuel?
Yes, look nice on Basil's bedside table.
Two in a day. That's as many as Van Gogh sold in a lifetime.
Ah, but he didn't have Manuel as a model, eh?
Wonderful.
I told you he's one of the best.
He's almost as good as you, Andre. Mm. He's absolutely divine, Basil. Go on, have a bit.
Mm. He's good, isn't he?
Oh, listen to him. The only place I've ever really seen him eat is your restaurant, Andre. Now he's stabbing it away like a hamster.
Really, Sybil?
We're going to have to buy him a great big wheel to run around in when he's got a motor toy. Or he'll get like a big bad-tempered tomato.
I believe we were discussing the gourmet evening, dear.
Do you know, Andre? Burst his zip this morning.
Oh.
What's the matter, darling?
You're embarrassing Andre.
No, dear, I'm embarrassing you. Look at that.
Well, I'd better go and have a word with the guests. Why don't you have another vat of wine, dear? Good evening, Major. Enjoying your soup?
Well, it tasted a bit off to me, Fawlty.
Well, it's made with fresh mushrooms, Major.
Ah, that would explain it.
Good evening. Everything to your satisfaction?
Oh,
well, I don't like the chips.
Sorry?
The chips are awful.
Oh, dear. What's wrong with them, then?
They're the wrong shape, and they're just awful.
I'm afraid he gets everything cooked the way he likes it at home.
Does he?
Yes, I do, and it's better than this pig's garbage.
Now, Ronald.
These eggs look like you laid them.
Ronald!
look here, old chap.
Shut up. Leave him alone. He's very clever, rather highly strung.
Yes, he should be. Well, these are proper French fried potatoes. You see, the chef is continental.
Couldn't you get an English one?
Why don't you eat just one or two, dear?
They're the wrong shape.
Oh, dear. What shape do you usually have? Mickey Mouse shape? Smarty shape? Amphibious landing craft shape? Poke in the eye shape?
God, you're dumb.
Oh, now?
Is there something we can get you instead, Sonny?
I'd like some bread and salad cream.
To eat? Well, there's the bread and there's the mayonnaise.
I said salad cream, stupid.
We don't have any salad cream. The chef made this freshly this morning.
What a dump.
This is very good.
He likes salad cream.
That's puke, that is.
Well, at least it's fresh puke.
Oh, dear.
When he said it.
May I ask why you don't have proper salad cream? I mean, most restaurants...
Well, the chef usually buys it only on special occasions, you know, gourmet nights and so on. But when he's got the bottle... Oh, he's a genius with it. He can unscrew the cap like Robert Carrier. It's a treat to watch. And then, right in the thing. Not on the walls. Magic. Mind you, he's a wizard with a tin opener, too. He's got a Pulitzer Prize for that. He can have the stuff in the saucepan before you can say haute cuisine. You name it, he'll heat it up and scrape it off the pan for you. Mind you, skill that isn't picked up overnight. Still, I'll tell him to get some salad cream. I mean, you never know when Henry Kissinger's going to drop in, do you? Oh, sorry. Sorry.
Nice man.
No, seriously, I think it's a very good idea.
You do really?
I promise you, people around here are getting more and more keen on good food.
Ah, so much for the night's guests, ignorant rabble.
There's always a few, Mr. Fawlty.
Well, not on gourmet night. There won't be none of these proles. Well.
I do think Thursday nights would be best.
Thursdays?
I think so.
Right, and on all the other nights, we'll just have a big trough of baked beans and garnish it with a couple of dead dogs.
Well, that's settled then.
Good. And I'm very pleased for Kurt, too. It will be good for him to have something special to do. I'd like to have a word with him. Do you mind?
No, of course not.
Right, well, I'll get the menus printed on Monday.
Polly can do the menus.
No, she can't.
Yes, she can.
No, she can't.
Yes, she can.
No, she can't.
Yes, she can. No. Yes, she can. You can write the advertisement in the Echo. Only don't make it too toffee-nosed, Basil. We don't want to put people off.
I just want to keep the riff-raff away, dear.
Well, good luck, my old friend. It's good to have you down here.
Thank you for, well, you know.
Don't mention it. Nice to have met you, Manuel.
He's my friend.
Oh, one night I cook you both paella.
Okay, and Kurt,
You don't trust me.
Ciao.
Manuel, together you and I make Fawlty Towers famous for its cooking.
Okay.
Excellent, tip-top, famoso. Oh, you are so cute.
Manuel? Oh. Get a clean one.
It's clean now.
Now.
Do you like the menu, Mr. Fawlty?
No, I don't.
Oh, good.
What?
Thank you so much.
Give it to me. Thank you.
Well, Basil, guess who just called to cancel at 12 minutes past 7?
Who?
The coasters.
What, all four?
Marvellous, isn't it?
Ah! What do they say?
One of them's ill.
Well, let's hope it's nothing trivial.
You realize there are four people at our grand opening dinner.
Never mind.
Never mind? There's four people, Basil. Shall we feed them in the kitchen?
But think who those four are. Colonel and Mrs. Hall, both JPs, and Lionel Twitchin, one of Torquay's leading Rotarians.
Well, that'll put us on the map.
He's this year's treasurer, dear.
I should never have let you write that advert. Fancy putting no riff-raff.
When you're presenting haute cuisine, you don't want the working class sticking its nose in it. Everything all right? Where's Kurt?
He and Manuel are getting the wine from the cellar.
Right. Ah, this is what it's all about. You two, you're supposed to be in your rooms.
What?
You're not allowed down here tonight, remember?
Oh, doesn't it look pretty?
What are you cooking?
I'll send you up a menu with your bread and cheese. Now, get up.
They're here.
What?
The halls are here.
Right. Go to your rooms. Mr. Fawlty. Mr. Fawlty, I'm very upset. Not now, Manuel, later.
When I went for my jog this morning, I thought it was going to be pretty warm. But in the event, of course, it turned out to be pretty cool, really. Then it began to cloud up this afternoon, quite contrary to the weather forecast, naturally. And I shouldn't be a bit surprised if we got a spot of rain tonight.
Still, it's been a lovely summer, hasn't it?
Oh, yes?
Colonel, how delightful to see you again.
Sorry?
How delightful to see you again. We met last year at the Golf Club dinner dance. You may remember.
No, I don't.
Ah, fine. Well, we didn't talk for long. Just good evening, really, you know. A blink in the eye, and you'd have missed it. As indeed you did. Quite understandably. Sorry?
What?
Well, how's that lovely daughter of yours?
She's dead.
I like your soup. Isn't that super? The way those stripes go up and down, it's really super. How much did that cost, then?
Who are you? I mean, I don't know your name.
What is it?
What?
My name.
Oh, this is my husband, Basil Fawlty.
That's it. What? Ah, thank you, dear.
How do you do?
May I introduce my wife?
Well, she just introduced you.
Oh, what a coincidence.
Yes. Well, I don't believe you know my wife. May I introduce Mrs. Hall?
Oh, sorry. Didn't see you down there. Don't get up.
What would you like to drink, Mrs. Small?
Hall? Yes. A short or...
Sherry. How about a sherry?
A sherry, lovely.
Oh, good. Large or not quite so large?
Too small and dry.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
What?
I don't know.
Two small, dry sherries.
Oh, I see what you mean. I'm sorry. Ah, Mr. and Mrs. Pidgeon. Good evening. Welcome to Fawlty Town.
Good evening.
How very au fait of you to come to our little culinary soiree this evening.
Only too glad to support something new in Torquay.
Such an unusual idea. I do hope it works out.
Well, we have our hopes.
Mr. Fawlty?
Ah, Polly, would you take Mrs. Twitchin's coat, please?
Yes, of course.
Thank you so much. Now, would you...
Mr. Fawlty?
Yes?
Can I have a word with you?
Yes. Oh, this is Polly. She will be serving you later this evening. Well?
It's Kurt.
Yes?
He's potted the shrimps.
What?
He's potted the shrimps.
Shrimps? I'm not having shrimps tonight, Polly. Now, would you...
He's soused the herring.
What are you all about?
He's pickled the onions, and he's smashed the eggs in his cups under the table.
Excuse me. Have you been drinking?
No, not me.
Well, will you behave yourself? I'm so sorry, Mr. Captain. Would you care for...
Please stop that! Just pull yourself together!
Now, may I offer you a little aperitif before you... Sorry. And may I offer you a little aperitif while you make up your mind what you would like for dinner?
That's very kind of you, not
A tomato juice, please.
Ah, Mr. Twitchin.
Yes, tomato juice for me, thank you.
Ah, good. Oh, Colonel. Colonel and Mrs. Hall. May I introduce Mr. and Mrs. Have you met?
No, we haven't.
Have you?
No.
Oh, good. Well, what would you like to drink, then?
What?
To drink?
I didn't catch the name.
Oh, you didn't catch it. What a rotten bit of luck.
Well,
fine, thank you. And you?
No, we still don't know the name.
Oh, Fawlty. Basil,
yes,
Fawlty.
Yes. No, there.
Oh, dear. So sorry. I thought you meant the horse. Ha, 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 ha. Isn't it? I can do the drink, too. So, another sherry?
Well, aren't you going to introduce us?
Didn't I?
No.
Oh, sorry. This is Mr. and Mrs. Farberson.
What?
Mr. and Mrs. Oh. Sorry, I fainted. Oh, I feel better for that. I'll just get you your tomato juices.
Oh, quite in, actually.
Paul, would you care to join us?
Thank you very much.
Here we are.
Would you like to see the menu?
Yes, what is it?
Please put the bottle down.
What do you want?
Please put the bottle down.
What is it?
Kurt is drunk.
Sorry. Drunk.
Almost unconscious.
Right. Sorry.
How?
I don't know. It happened so quickly. He had a row with Manuel. And
Manuel?
He's got a crush on him.
A what?
A crush, you know, in love.
Oh! Sorry. Would you excuse me just one moment? I won't be one moment. I should never have hired a Frenchman.
He's Greek, Mr. Fawlty.
Greek?
Of course.
Well, that's even worse. I mean, they invented it. Right. Give that to me, Kurt.
Come on, give me that bottle.
Now go away. Leave me alone.
Come on, give it to me.
Manuel! Manuel, he doesn't love me.
Well, you have to give these things time.
I want Manuel.
Well, I'm sure we can arrange something. Now, can I have the bottle?
He's so sweet.
Yes, he is sweet, I know, yes.
He's wonderful.
Yes, yes, I know. Cut! Come on. Get some black coffee, quick.
He can't drink it, he's out.
There he isn't, he's only drunk half a bottle. Come on, Kurt. Come on, Kurt.
Now listen to me, Kurtie, listen. I come in now, but no cuddles, you hear me? No
cuddles.
Dead?
Tell the world.
He's only drunk, Manuel.
This is your fault.
Okay?
You only had to be civil to him.
Civil?
Nice.
No, you don't understand. He's not enough. He wants to kiss me.
Oh, what one little...
Mr. Fawlty, call Andre. He can do the cooking.
He's open tonight. He's open on a Thursday, you clothy-eared beast.
But he can do it there, and you can pick it up at the car.
Oh. Brilliant.
Oh.
Brilliant.
Ugh.
Right.
I can't resist lobster.
Turn it over me every time.
Will you care for another drink?
No, I don't think we will. We're nearly ready to order.
I'll be back in a moment.
So you can't do the lobster? No, right, I see, but Andre, the tornadoes. Yes, I'm sorry.
That?
Shh. Yes, of course I want the duck, that's marvellous, but, I mean, can you do one or two sauces? Wonderful, that's it. Thank you, Andre.
What are you talking to, Andre?
What is it?
Where is the water bottle?
Well, stall them.
What?
Stall them, you stupid woman. Tell them some lies.
What's happening? Shh. You can't tell me what you're doing.
We've got to change the menu.
Why?
Listen, he's out there. He's out. He's flat out. So Andre's...
Who is?
What?
Who is out?
Kurt, who do you think? Henry Kissinger?
What do you mean out?
He's drunk.
Drunk?
Drunk, soused, potted, inebriated. Got it?
I don't believe it.
Neither do I. Perhaps it's a dream. No, it's not a dream. We're stuck with it. Right. Andre's doing the cooking. I'll collect it in the car.
What's he cooking?
Duck.
Duck?
Duck.
Duck?
You know, duck! I'm so sorry to have kept you waiting.
Well, we'd like to order now.
Yes, quite.
My wife would like the lobster as her menu.
Yes, excuse me. There is one small thing. I'm afraid you were given the wrong menus. This is tonight's menu.
What?
Yes, I'm afraid the chef changed his mind and forgot to tell us. He's like that. Brilliant, but temperamental.
What? He's changed everything?
I'm afraid so. Yes, it wasn't good enough, so he just chucked it away. He's such a perfectionist.
The lobster,
tornado, you name it, it's in the bin.
Extraordinary.
Yes, lucky old bin, I say. So, this is your new menu.
Duck with orange, duck with cherries, duck surprise.
What's duck surprise?
That's duck without orange or cherries.
I mean, is this all there is, duck?
Yes, done, of course, the three extremely different ways.
And what you'll do if you don't like duck?
Well, if you don't like duck, you're rather stuck.
Well, fortunately, I love it.
Oh, good. So, that's four ducks, is it?
You were right. Oh. Now, he's getting his duck from Andre.
Yes, but I don't know what vegetables he's put on.
Three salmouches, Polly, and one mullet with mustard sauce for Mrs. Hall. Right, where is the mullet?
There.
Oh, right.
What are you doing about vegetables, Basil?
Same as the other menu, dear.
Andre's not doing anything.
No, no, you know them, you and Polly. Mustard sauce.
Mustard sauce, yeah.
Right, now, while I'm out in the car, you get them ready, right?
Right,
ready, Polly?
Ready.
Manuel?
Si.
Right, two of those for table 9, and one of those, and that for table 4.
Si.
Come on. Right.
Very good.
No, the other way round.
Okay?
The other way round.
Four,
please.
Yeah, four,
what? No, the plates. Change the plates.
Four, it's dirty, I changed.
Yeah. No. Come here. Change the plates. Sorry, see, it's wrong.
I'm so sorry. He's from Barcelona. Do forgive me.
I don't know what he's teasing you.
Oh,
Do you think we could have a drink, dear?
May I see the wine list, please, Fawlty?
Certainly, Major. Colonel! Everything all right?
Yes.
Good. Mrs. Twitchin?
Yes, it's fine.
Good. He's got it in his hair.
How is it, dear?
Rather good, surprisingly.
Well, there's the wine list.
Oh, thank you very much.
Ah! Oh!
What is it, Petrel? What's the matter?
Oh!
Is everything all right?
Oh, I think I'm going to be sick.
It is an unusual taste, isn't it?
It's not cooked, you ignoramus.
What are you trying to do to us, Fawlty? You mean that's raw?
Oh, would you prefer a cooked one?
Of course, even a cooked one.
Oh, it's a cooked one, then. It'll be even nicer.
No!
This is raw. This mullet is raw. I mean, what are we going to do to it?
Kurt, listen. What do we do to this, Do we grill it? If we grill it, just go, oh. All right, do we fry it? Just go, oh.
Have you chosen yet, Major? Colonel? Have you chosen your wine?
Oh, yes, Chablis, please.
Thank you.
Waitress.
Yes?
There's a hare in my mousse.
Well, don't talk too loud. Everybody will want one.
What?
Get out of the plane. Ouch. No. I'm so sorry about that. The mullet's on its way.
Ah, Monsieur Fawlty, there you are. A beautiful bag for you. It should be delicious. Top. Hello, Chanel. Top. He's always asleep. There you are. Don't forget the sauces.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Goodbye. Oh,
Mark. Thank you. All does
very well for you.
Good luck. Come on. What,
no good?
No, it's very good.
Right, I'll come in on the trolley. Well done, everybody. Come on, well, get the trolley ready. Right, let's go.
Well, I'm afraid he got trodden on.
Sorry, it's her wrong. Try again.
I'm Jessica.
girl who can't say no. I'm in a terrible fix.
Come!
Sign of the duck.
Oh, it's just coming.
So Uncle Ted comes in with his crate of brown ale and and Mother says, "Oh, Ted, look who's here." And he says, "Ah!"
Okay, Polly.
Okay.
Got the sauces?
Got them.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, so sorry I don't catch you waiting.
About the duck, Fawlty.
Duck's off, sorry.
Lovely part of the world, isn't it? All those beautiful trees and fields and variety of birds.
Yes, that's true.
And you can just go there and get away from it all, away from the helter-skelter of modern life, because we all do need our solitude, don't we?
Yes, we do.
I mean, nowadays it's not easy to find the time to, I don't know, enjoy life, because there's always things to do. It's all so hectic, isn't it? All of us just rushing around, letting things get on top of us. And quite honestly, what's the point?
Have you finished?
Yes.
Thank you, my wife.
I think those prawns might be a bit off.
Oh, I don't think so.
Well, they do taste rather funny.
Well, no one else has complained.
Well, I really do think they're off.
But you've eaten half of them.
Well, I didn't notice at the start.
You didn't notice at the start?
No, but it was a sauce. I wasn't sure.
So you ate half to make sure?
Look, my wife thinks they're off.
Well, what about... do you want another first course?
No, thank you.
Are you sure?
No, really. I'll just have the main.
Well, cancel it.
Cancel it? Oh, deduct it from the bill. Is that what you mean?
As it's inedible.
Well, only half of it's inedible, apparently.
Well, deduct half now. And if my wife brings the other half up during the night, we'll claim the balance in the morning. Now it's like our last.
Well, three we know have passed on this year, all in their early 60s. So I've cut out butter, and I tell you what I'm going to do.
Thank you.
No, really. It's all right.
But it's all bristles.
No, honestly. Oh, there's a nice bit, see?
Oh, Doris, it's awful.
Oh, no, dear. It's not as bad as that. I've had worse.
I don't know how they get away with it.
Everything all right?
Oh yes,
thank you. Thank you. Everything to your satisfaction?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Why don't you say something?
Well, there's no point, is there? We just won't come here again.
Then I'll say something.
Look, it won't do any good. We're leaving tomorrow.
Well, I'm going to. I mean, we've been sitting here waiting for nearly half an hour, and it's...
What's this?
See?
Look, I ordered the cold meat salad, and I've been waiting about half an hour for it.
Salad?
Yes.
You want change?
No, I don't want to change.
Okay.
Where are you going? No, I don't want this.
You say you don't want change.
I want the salad.
Don't
walk. Oh, excuse me.
Yes?
Look, we've been waiting here for about half an hour now. I mean, I gave the waiter our order.
Oh, him, he's hopeless, isn't he?
Yeah, well, I don't wish to complain, but when he does bring something, he's got it wrong.
Well, you think I don't know? I mean, you only have to eat here. We have to live with it. I had to pay his fare all the way from Barcelona, but you can't get the staff, you see. It's a nightmare.
You were supposed to be complaining to him.
Sorry about that.
Thank you. Thank
you.
No.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy your meal.
You haven't forgotten.
They're coming.
Excuse me. There's sugar in the salt cellar.
Anything else?
I put it all over the place.
All over the place? What were you doing with it?
All over the place.
Oh, Polly, would you ask Terry not to finish yet? We need another one of these. There is sugar on it.
What a sweet place.
What?
I'll have it replaced.
Well, why is there sugar in this salt cellar? What do you think we pay you for?
My staying power.
For lamps.
Yes, I'm getting them.
Excuse me.
Yes?
I'm sorry, but do you think we could cancel our fruit salad?
Well, it's a little tricky. Chef's just opened the tin.
Oh.
I didn't mind. I'm sure it'll be very nice. There we are.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, yes, I do like really beautiful places.
Busy this evening, isn't it?
I tell you, one of my favourites.
I said it's busy this evening.
I'm talking to Mr. Libson, Basil.
Good, well, that's a help.
I'm sure you can cope.
Oh, yes, I can cope, dear. Coping's easy, not pureeing your loved ones. That's the difficult part.
Did you know Biddeford Bridge has all different sizes?
Yes, there's someone at reception, dear. Shall I get it?
Yes.
It's my turn, is it? Fine. Yes. Oh, yes, so it is. Yes, funny, it's been my turn for 15 years. Still, when I'm dead, it'll be your turn, dear. You'll be it.
Excuse me, there are two lambs here.
I'll have them removed if they're bothering you. Yes.
Good evening.
Are those ours?
Not yet.
Good evening.
I reserved a room by telephone this morning. Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton.
Indeed, yes, I remember it well. Ah, excellent. Hamilton, yes.
That's right.
Well, may I welcome you to Fawlty Towers. I trust your stay will be an enjoyable and a gracious one.
Could we have those now?
Oh, by all means.
Finished with them, have you?
Absolutely. Bon appétit.
I recommend the self-service here. It's excellent.
We all thank you.
What?
Your lambs will be getting cold, Mr. Johnston.
Colder?
If you'd like them warmed up.
Forget it.
You could get your wife to sit on them. I'm so sorry with the rubbish we get in here. Now, if you'd be so very kind as to fill that form out, Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton. Ah, yes. Now, we put you in room 12, which has a charming panoramic view overlooking the lawn.
What a driver. Everything on the wrong side of the road, the weather.
What do you get for living in a climate like this? Green stamps, it's terrible.
Sorry about this.
Took 5 hours from London. Couldn't find the freeway. Had to take a little back street called the M5.
Well, I'm sorry if it wasn't wide enough for you. A lot of the English cars have steering wheels.
They do, do they? You wouldn't think there was room for them inside.
See what I mean?
What?
Well, I'm...
May I introduce my husband?
All the rubbish we get in here. Look at that. More
rubbish, dear.
What?
More of that bloody rubbish.
Harley and Manuel are going, Basil.
Yes, just eating with Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton, dear.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Manuel will bring your bags to your rooms. I hope you enjoy your stay and...
Thank you. Do we need to reserve a table for dinner?
Dinner?
Yes. Problem?
Well, it is after nine.
So?
Well, we do actually stop serving at nine.
Nine?
Well, look, if you could go straight in...
Yes, we have 5 hours to get here. We'd like to freshen up, maybe have a drink first, you know.
Yes, you couldn't do that afterwards?
Do what?
Well,
You mean have our drink before dinner, after dinner, freshen up and go to bed?
But if you could, it would make things easier for us.
Shall we go to bed now? Would that make it easier for you? We're a little tired, fellow. We want to sit up and relax. We'll be down in a few minutes.
Yes, but the shift does actually stop at nine.
Nine. Nine. So why does your shift stop at nine, huh? You got something terminal?
No, but that's when he, in fact, stops.
Now, look, we drove from London to stay here, right? Are you telling me that you can't stay open a few minutes longer so that we can eat properly?
Well, we can do your sandwiches. Ham? Cheese?
We want something hot.
Toasted sandwiches?
You're joking. Not really. Can you believe this? What the hell's wrong with this country? You can't get a drink after three, you can't eat after nine. Is the war still on?
No, but it's the staff, you see.
Oh, the staff.
We have to get the staff.
How much? How much of this Mickey Mouse money do you want to keep the chef on for half an hour? One, two, three, £20, huh? Is that enough?
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
Madam, excuse me, please. Please. This way. Please.
Or aquí. This way, please. Gosh, that does look absolutely marvelous.
Oh, Terry, I almost forgot. Some guests have just arrived, right at the last moment, as usual. Typical. I'm sorry, but this puts us out just as much as it puts you out.
Don't put me out, Mr. Fawlty.
No, but they want some dinner, you see, and they insist first on scraping off some of the filth that somehow got caked to them cruising down the M5.
Well, I've got my class tonight, Mr. Fawlty.
But Terry...
Ready, Terry?
Righto, Paul. No, wait, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I will make it up to you, you know, out of my own pocket.
It's not the money, Mr. Fawlty. My karate means a lot to me.
All right, half an hour's overtime in a taxi.
Mr. Fawlty, if I miss a week, next week I don't get out in one piece.
An hour's out.
Sorry, Mr. Fawlty.
What am I going to say to him?
2 hours.
What?
2 hours overtime.
I thought you said it wasn't the money.
It ain't, but I can't think what you're going to say to your guests.
Look, Terry, I'd pay you 2 hours overtime if I could afford it.
Sorry, Mr. Fawlty.
An hour and a half.
Cash?
Cash.
All right, hour and a half, but I go at 9:30, then I still get some of me class, right?
Well, and I do the washing up.
Well, you know how it is, Mr. Fawlty.
Yes, I know how it is. I pay you for an hour and a half, you clear off after half an hour. That's how it is. That's socialism.
Oh, no. That's the free market.
Come on, Terry. Nothing keep the lady waiting.
The lady?
She's from Finland, Mr. Fawlty, and very pretty. Tall, block.
This Finnish floozy's your karate teacher, is
she? Well... the sort of karate, innit?
Right, give me that.
What?
I pay you overtime to miss a class, not to keep some bit of crumpet hanging around.
Yeah, but you...
No, it's all right. I'm doing the washing up. I'll do the cooking, too. You go off and enjoy yourself. Don't you worry about me. You go and have a good time. I'll be all right. Go and have a bit of fun with a Finn.
Come on, Manuel.
Where are you? Polly, where are... Hey, wait for me. Wait for me. It's Billy.
If you'd care to sit over there.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Is your room to your liking?
Yes, very nice.
Very nice, thank you.
Oh, good.
I'll just get you tonight's menu. Oh, would you care for a drink before your meal?
Scotch and water and a screwdriver, please.
And for you, madam?
The screwdriver's for me.
I see. Would you like it now or after meal?
Well, now, please.
There's nothing I can put right?
What?
Absolutely. So it's one scotch and a screwdriver.
I think I'll join you. Make that two screwdrivers, would you?
You'd like a screwdriver as well?
Got it.
Fine. So it's one scotch and you each need a screwdriver.
No. Forget the scotch, two screwdrivers.
I understand. And you'll leave the drinks.
What?
Nothing to drink?
What do you mean, nothing to drink?
Well, you can't drink your screwdrivers, can you?
What else would you suggest that we do with
them? Vodka and orange juice.
Oh, certainly, madam.
Make that two and forget about the screwdrivers.
You sure?
You can manage without them.
As you wish.
You Relax in the carefree atmosphere of old English charm. When you are there... I hope we're not intruding on your dinner hour.
Oh, not at all, no. You're American.
That's right.
Where are you from?
California.
How lovely. You're English, though.
Yes, but I've been over there 10 years now.
10 years? Do you ever get homesick?
Oh, yes, but I love it there. The climate's so wonderful. You can swim and sunbathe and then after lunch drive up into the mountains and ski.
How wonderful.
I like England and the English people, but I sure couldn't take this climate.
Harry finds it too gloomy.
Oh, I don't find it too gloomy, the usable.
Yes, I do, Basil.
Oh, yes, my wife finds it too gloomy. I find it rather bracing.
What do you find bracing, Basil? The damp, the drizzle, the fog?
Well, it's not always like this, dear. It changes.
My husband's like the climate. He changes. This morning he went on for 2 hours about the bloody weather.
It has been unusually damp this week, in fact, but normally we're rather spoiled down here on the English Riviera.
Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton were telling me about California. You can swim in the morning and then in the afternoon you can drive up into the mountains and ski.
Must be rather tiring.
Well, one has a choice.
Yes, well, I don't think it would suit me. I rather like it down here. It's very mild all the year round. We have palm trees here in Torquay, you know. Do you have palm trees in California?
Burt Lancaster had one, they say, but I don't believe him. What the hell is that?
Vodka and orange juice.
Orange juice.
I'm afraid it's not fresh.
Isn't it?
No.
We've just opened the bottle.
Look, fresh means it comes out of an orange, not out of a bottle.
Ah, you'd like freshly squeezed orange juice.
As opposed to freshly unscrewed orange juice, yes.
Leave it to me. I mean, I'll get Chef onto it straight away.
Sorry about that. A lot of English people are used to the flavour of the bottle.
Oh, it's all right. It's just that back home, fresh orange juice comes like running water.
Does it really? Of course, it's so good for your skin, isn't it? I'd love to go to California someday. Looks so exciting.
Oh, never love a stranger. Do you like it?
Oh, I love all Harold Robbins. I've read this one 3 times.
The Pirates is his best, I think. I read them when Harry's away. I just don't seem to have the time when he's home.
Who needs Harold Robbins when you've got the real thing?
How long have you been married, Mrs. Fawlty?
Oh, since 1485.
There we are. Fresh orange juice.
Thank you.
Seriously, though, his men are all so interesting. Ruthless and sexy and powerful.
Who's this then, dear? Proust, E.M. Forster?
Harold Robbins.
Oh, yes, of course, yes. My wife likes Harold Robbins. After a hard day slaving under the hairdryer, she needs one wine with a few aimless thrills. Have you ever read any? Oh, really is the most awful American... Well, not American. Transatlantic tripe, sort of... pornographic Muzak. Still, keeps my wife off the street.
We both like him.
Oh, Robbins.
What?
Harold Robbins. Oh, I thought you meant that awful man. What's his name? Harold Robinson. Have you read any Harold Robinson? Oh, painful. Oh.
How about Waldorf Salad?
Was that one? Yes, you're absolutely right. Oh, that was a shock, wasn't it?
Could you make me a Waldorf Salad?
Waldorf
salad.
Well, I think we're just out of Waldorf.
I don't believe it.
It's not very well known here, Harry.
Yes, may I recommend tonight...
Now, look, I'm sure your chef knows how to fix me a Waldorf salad, huh?
Well, I wouldn't be too sure.
Well, he's a chef, isn't he?
Yes, yes, you wouldn't prefer...
Well, find out, will you? Just go out there and see if he knows how to fix me a Waldorf salad.
Of course, yes. He's not absolutely positive. He's almost got it. It's lettuce and tomato, walnuts...
No. It's celery, apples, walnuts, grapes.
In a mayonnaise sauce.
Right. Incidentally, he did ask me to say that he does specially recommend the patty tonight.
I don't want patty.
Or the grapefruit?
Grape.
The grapefruit.
Mm-hmm. How's it done?
Well, it's halved with a cherry in the centre.
Look, I haven't paid you £20 to have some guy cut a grapefruit in half and stick a cherry in the centre.
Exactly.
I want a Waldorf salad.
Absolutely. One Waldorf salad.
And a green salad for me.
And one green salad, yes. And if we can't manage the Waldorf salad...
I want a Waldorf salad. And to follow, a couple of filet mignons.
Steak.
Done rare. Not out of a bottle.
Not out of a bottle, right.
Would you care to see the wine list?
Thank you.
May I ask, did you say you'd pay £20?
Yes, but it's not the money. My wife and I, we wanted dinner and...
This can't be right. There's no reason Chef couldn't stay.
I'm awfully sorry. He's forgotten already. Walnuts, cheese...
No! No cheese! It's celery, apples, walnuts, grapes.
Right.
In mayonnaise.
Right. Now, come on.
Would you excuse me one moment?
Excuse me. A bottle of bullnay, please.
Of course. Thank you.
What's this about £20,
Basil? No celery, would you believe it?
I'll find the celery. What about this £20?
He gave me £20 to keep the kitchens open and chef wouldn't. I mean, where does he put things?
If you just look.
I have looked. There's no celery, there's no grapes, walnuts. That's a laugh. Easier to find a packet of sliced hippopotamus and suitcase sauce in the water.
Now we've got apples.
Oh, terrific. We'll celebrate. We'll have an apple party. Everybody brings his own apple and toast it down somebody's throat.
I will find everything. Just go and get a bottle of walnut.
What is a Waldorf anyway? A walnut that's gone off?
The hotel, Basil. The Waldorf Hotel in New York.
Wait.
Basil.
Everything all right?
Yes, thank you.
Never been better.
Oh, good. By the way, I wonder, have you by any chance ever tried a Ritz salad?
Ritz salad?
Yes, it's a traditional old English thing. It's apples, grapefruit and potatoes in a mayonnaise sauce.
No, I don't think I ever tried that.
Ah.
Don't think I ever will either.
Yeah, well, that's probably pretty sound. Well, look, about this Waldorf salad of yours.
Yes?
You're having a bit of a tete-a-tete with Chef, and the point is, we're all right on the apples. Absolutely no problem with them at all. Now, on the celery front, well, perhaps I should explain. We normally get our celery delivered on a Wednesday, along with our cabbages, onions, walnuts, grapes, that sort of thing. But this week, the driver...
Mr. Fawlty.
Yes, he was putting the crate into the van.
I'm not
And he sort of slipped forward, and the van door caught his arm like that, and he may have fractured it.
You don't have it.
They did the x-rays, and we'll know tomorrow whether they're going to have to operate. And to cut a long story short, we don't have any, no. But, So, makes you think how lucky you are, doesn't it? I mean, here we all are, with all our limbs functioning. I mean, quite frankly, if you've got your health, what else matters?
What a bunch of crap.
Oh, do you think so? I always feel like...
What the hell's going on here? It says hotel outside. Now, is this a hotel or isn't it?
Well, within reason.
You know something, fella? If this was back in the States, I wouldn't board my dog here.
Fussy, is he? Poodle?
Oh. Poodle. I'm not getting through to you, am I? You know, I stay in hotels all over the world. And this is the first time I've had to bribe a chef to cook me a meal and then find out he doesn't even have the basic goddamn ingredients. Holy cow, can't you see what a crummy dump this is?
You listen to this, are you kidding?
I'm talking to you.
It's all right, Terry, you can get
Shut up, will you? Listen to me. Can't you see this ain't good enough?
Yes, I see what you mean.
And then you give me some half-assed story about some delivery guy busting his arm. Now, look, Fawlty, if your chef couldn't find the ingredients from that guy, why didn't he get them from somebody else, huh?
Exactly.
Yeah. Hopeless. What?
It's hopeless. Completely hopeless.
Right. You're the manager, aren't you? You're responsible. So what are you going to do about it, huh?
I'll have a word. Have a word.
Man, you've got to tell him. Lay it on the line.
Lay it on the line.
Tell him if he doesn't get on the ball, you're going to bust his ass.
Bust his?
I'll tell him.
No. I'll tell him. Leave it to me. I've got it. Bust his ass. All that. And two green salads.
Here we are. One green salad and one Mordor salad.
I thought
yes.
That...
Oh, would you excuse me one moment?
You hear me? It's not good enough.
Help! It's just
coming
through. Help it off.
That's a bunch of arse. That's what that is.
It's fine.
Why can't you make a Waldorf salad?
Waldorf salad.
No!
First thing tomorrow, you get the ingredients for Waldorf salad, or I'm going to break your bottom.
Oh, no, you don't.
No, I mean it.
Everything all right?
Yes, thank you.
You're sure there's nothing?
No, it's very good.
Oh, good.
Oh, you're a chef.
Yes.
Has he been with you long?
About 6 months. He used to work at Dorchester.
At the Dorchester?
No, in Dorchester, about 40 miles away.
Here we are, two green salads.
Basil.
Is there?
Mr. Hamilton has his Waldorf salad, dear.
No, dear, chef couldn't make it. He didn't have the ingredients. I've just smashed his backside about it.
But there it is.
What?
There's the Waldorf salad. Chef found the ingredients.
Fine.
Well, if he found the ingredients, why didn't he tell me?
Wouldn't it have been struck dumb when somebody tore his tongue out in the last 2 minutes?
Maybe Robinson's arm got better.
I'm sorry about it.
All right.
No, it isn't.
It doesn't matter.
Well, it matters to me.
Not to me. I've got my Waldorf salad.
Yes, excuse me.
For God's sake!
Chef,
would you bring that back immediately? I'm so sorry. I'll just get it back for you.
Sorry? I'll give him sorry. Get off your knees.
No,
I haven't finished. The chef yet, Simone. Why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you tell me you found them, you stupid cow? Hey, Chef, no, I haven't finished. You can have it enough.
Sorry about that little confusion. Chef hasn't been with us very long, and we've just reorganized the kitchen.
Thank you.
Oh, you haven't got your wine yet. Basil! Won't be a moment. Basil!
Yes,
Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton haven't got their wine yet. And Basil, has Chef put the steaks on yet?
No, I'll tell you.
Right.
Is your husband all right?
Oh, yes, he's just had rather a long day.
There's just the two of you here, right?
We haven't had a proper holiday for 8 years.
8 years?
Yes. I have to get away occasionally, just for a few hours, even if it's just out of a hairdresser or a round of golf or a bridge evening with some of the girls. Drive in the country sometimes, just on my own. Pop down to Cornwall for the day. Sometimes it's beautiful there.
You'll go there, sir.
Yes, you must visit Cornwall while you're here.
Thank you. Incidentally, I've been talking to Chef and we've sorted out what happened. Apparently, he thought that he'd already got...
That's very nice, thank you.
Thank you. Got two orders for Waldorf salad, you see. And in fact, he had the ingredients, but...
No, that's...
Until he made one, he didn't realise that he didn't have enough for the second one.
Look, don't let it bother you.
No, anyway, this will explain everything.
What's that?
A letter. A letter from the chef. It explained everything.
Letter from the chef.
Yes, he wanted to apologize personally, but I didn't want him wasting your time, so I thought...
Look, just forget about it, will you?
Well, I'll read it for
you. I want my
snake. Well, be a moment. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton, I hope you're well. This is just a brief note to say that I take full responsibility for the dreadful mess-ups tonight. If I'd only listened to Mr. Fawlty, none of this fiasco would have occurred. I'd just like to tell you that such a cock-up has never occurred in my career before, and that now everything has been sorted out, I'll be back to my very best form. Signed, Terry.
Just about enough of this.
Harry. How could you forget about it? What was
making another Waldorf salad? Making another Waldorf salad? What are you making another Waldorf salad for? Don't
get rid of all this. I don't need it, man.
Well, what do you think, Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton, would think? With them.
Mr. Hamilton, may I introduce Terry Hugh?
What did he go?
Where's he gone? Did you see him?
Maybe he went to get something to eat. Come on, honey.
What is it, Harry?
We're leaving.
Well, what's happened?
I'll tell you later.
Yes, your steak will be ready in a moment, Mrs. Hamilton. He must have heard you coming, you know, and panicked and run out into the yard. You know, after all the problems we've...
How big a butterball do you take me for?
But...
Do you think I don't know what's been going on out there?
Oh, bit of a debark, I'm afraid.
I'm talking about you taking 20 pounds off me to keep the chef on, letting him go, cooking the meal yourself, and then pretending he's still out there.
Oh, that?
Yes, that. And I'd be interested to know what you've got to say about it.
Good evening.
I asked you a question.
Yes, well, I'm sorry that your meal has not been fully satisfactory this evening.
What I'm suggesting is that this place is the crummiest, shoddiest, worst-run hotel in the whole of Western Europe. No! No, I won't have that. There's a place in Eastbourne. And that you are the British tourist board's answer to Donald Duck.
Now, look, I know things have gone wrong this evening, but you must remember that we have had thousands of satisfied customers.
All right, let's ask them, eh? What? Let's ask them. Are you all satisfied?
You, are you
Major,
satisfied?
Major, are you satisfied? I mean, you've been here 7 years. Are you satisfied?
Oh, sure, I love it here.
Major, are you satisfied?
Oh, yes, thank you, Mr. Fawlty, yes. And thank you for asking.
Not at all. Mr. Arrow, are you satisfied?
Well, yes, Mrs. Gerd, you?
Oh, very nice, sir, yes.
You see, satisfied customers. Of course, if this little hotel is not to your taste, then you are free to say so. That is your privilege. And I shall, of course, refund your money. I know how important it is to you Americans. But you must remember that here in Britain, there are things that we value more. Things that perhaps in America you've rather forgotten about, but which to we British are far, far more important.
I'm not satisfied.
But what?
I'm not satisfied.
No, we're not satisfied.
Well, people like you never are you?
What?
Well, something I could do would please a pair like you, short of putting straw in the rooms.
I think you're the rudest man I've ever met.
I haven't started yet.
You're not going to. You're going to stand here nice and quiet while these people say whether or not they're satisfied, and you move off that spot, Fawlty, and I'm going to bust your ass.
Everything's bottoms, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
I think this is probably the worst hotel we've ever stayed in.
Yes, it is. The service here is an absolute disgrace.
I agree.
You do?
Yes. Do you know that we had to wait nearly half an hour for our main course, and when it arrived, it was wrong?
Well, I complained. He completely fobbed me off with some rubbish around
my the prawns way. Were off, and when I told him, there was an argument.
And her meat was off before.
And I asked you to fix my radiator 3 times, and nothing's been done.
Satisfied customers, huh?
Hot dog.
This is typical. Absolutely typical. The kind of ass I had to put up with from you people. You punts in here expecting to be hand-waited on hand and foot while I'm trying to run a hotel here. Have you any idea of how much there is to do? Do you ever think of that? Of course not. You're too busy sticking your noses into every corner, poking about for things to complain about, aren't you? Well, let me tell you something. This is exactly how Nazi Germany started. With nothing better to do than to cause trouble. Well, I've had 15 years of pandering to the likes of you, and I've had enough. I've had it. Come on, pack your bags and get out.
They're packed.
Order 10 taxis, will you? I'll pay for them.
Come on, come on.
What?
Out. Everybody out. Come on upstairs. Pack your bags. Adios. Out.
But it's raining.
Well, you should have thought of that before, shouldn't you? Too late now. Come on out. Rouse. 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 Well, let me explain my little workhorse. The guests and I have been having a bit of an old chinwag, and the upshot of it all is they're off. Off? Well, let me put it this way, dear. Either they go or I go. Right, come on back, everybody. My wife had a better idea. Come on back. I'm going instead. Well, goodbye, dear. It's been an interesting 15 years, but all good things must come to an end. I hope you enjoy your new work here, helping to run a hotel. Goodbye, Major. Goodbye, ladies. Give my regards to Polly and Manuel. Bye, dear.
You've forgotten your key, Basil.
So I have, dear, yes. Oh, and goodbye to the rest of you. I hope you enjoy your stay here. Don't forget any complaints. Don't hesitate to tell my wife. Any hour of the day or night, just shout. Bye! Bye.
That'll be fine.
Here. Hello, dear. I'm back.
What do you want, Basil?
A room, please. Number 12 is free, I think. Now, I'd like breakfast in bed at 10:30 in the morning, please. That's eggs, bacon, sausage and tomato with a Waldorf salad. I'll wash down with the lashings of hot screwdriver.
And he simply adores those little cheese footballs, don't you, my darling? Oh, isn't he beautiful?
Very attractive little fella. What is it?
He's a little shih tzu.
Really? Oh, dear, dear, dear. What breed is it?
Well, they're are lap dogs, aren't they?
A lap dog? Oh, hard to imagine him stalking a reindeer, what?
Major, can I get you another one?
Why not?
Good. For you, Mrs. Chase?
Oh, nothing for me, thank you. But Prince would like a little saucer of warm milk, because it's nearly our bedtime.
Yes, Manuel. Manuel will attend to its heart's desires. I'm afraid I'm lumbered with the people tonight. Manuel, por favor, el perro microscopico.
Oh, good evening, Dr. Fry.
Good evening.
What can I get you?
Scotch, please. And I suppose it's too late to get anything to eat, is it? I missed dinner.
What did you have in mind?
Well, I rather fancy some sausages.
Oh, I'm afraid Chef would have locked them away. We could do you sandwiches. Ham, cheese, tomato.
Ham, thank you.
Right, I'll just arrange it for you. Basil!
So,
could you make some ham sandwiches, please?
Look, I'm
Dr. Fry.
Oh, of course. Yes, one moment, Doctor. Here we are, Major.
Excuse me, Sloane.
Found another draft, have we?
We have to be very careful, Mr. Fawlty. He's not very strong.
Indeed, yes. A rapid movement of air could damage him irreparably. If only one could keep them in airtight containers.
He had to breathe, would he, Fawlty?
Well, he could try, Major. He could try. Anything else, Fuel?
No, thank you. No, it's a bit late. We'd better get upstairs.
Quite. Sorry to have kept you. Doctor, one round, two.
Just one, please.
My pleasure.
No. She was the one he had with him the third time. The first one was the dowdy one, then his wife, then her, and now this red. Oh, yes, that must have been lovely. Number 12. Let's see.
Thank you.
How very lovely. Yes, that was them. Not much. They get less fussy as they get older.
Sorry about this.
Please, it couldn't matter less. We're meeting in the morning anyway.
You've had a long journey.
Mm. You get a good night's sleep.
Are you sure you're feeling all right?
Oh, fine. Just a little...
Oh, yes, of course.
Well, you get straight to bed and we'll pick you up here at 9:30.
We'll have a coffee and go into the MD at 10.
Fine, thanks, okay. Good night.
Good night.
Yes. Sleep well.
Good night. Bye.
See you in the morning.
Yes. See you at 9:30. Sorry.
Harris? Oh, no, on his own again. Oh, no. I wouldn't have thought so. He watches the football. Number 8, isn't
Thank
it?
Thank you.
Well, are you feeling all right?
Not too good, no.
Oh, dear. Would you like a little hot something?
Oh, no. Fine, thank you.
Oh, well, if there's anything you need.
Yes, thank you.
No, that wasn't him. That was a new one.
Good night. I said good night.
Oh, good night.
Didn't hurt, did it? Good manners cost nothing, no.
He's not feeling very well, Basil.
You only have to say good night, dear. It's not the Gettysburg address, is it?
Basil, when you're not feeling well...
Just two little words, dear. Get a little happiness into the world.
Excuse me.
Yes, Mr. Lehman, what can I do for you?
Do you think I might have breakfast in bed in the morning?
In bed?
Yes.
Of course, Mr. Lehman.
Oh, yes, we can manage there, can we do
that? Yes, we can. I'll pull you back.
Yes, is it your legs?
I'm sorry.
Well, most of our guests managed to struggle down in the morning. I wanted to...
A full breakfast or the continental?
Oh, I don't know.
Our chef does a very good full breakfast. Eggs, bacon, sausage, tomato, fried bread.
The continental.
You wouldn't care for kippers?
Oh, fine. Kippers, yes, thank you.
Toast, butter, marmalade.
Yes, thank you.
Tea or coffee?
Yes. Tea, thank you.
A newspaper?
The Telegraph.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Rosewood, mahogany, teak.
I beg your pardon.
What would you like your breakfast tray made out of?
I don't really mind.
Are you sure? Fine. Well, you go along and have a really good night's sleep then. I'm hoping to get a couple of hours later on myself. I'll be up in good time to serve you your breakfast in bed. If you can remember to sleep with your mouth open, you won't even have to wake up. I'll just drop in small pieces of lightly buttered kipper when you're breathing in the right direction, if that doesn't switch you out. Ethel?
Sausages, please.
Just sausages?
Just sausages.
Tea or coffee?
Coffee, please.
But he's...
Oh, no, not a saucer.
Come on.
I said a bowl.
A boy.
Yes, and not cold like that. That's too cold. I said tepid, didn't I?
Mas grande, Manuel. De agua caliente.
Ah.
Catch pneumonia from that. And bring another cushion. He's not quite high enough.
Sausages on 6, Terry.
Coming out.
Grande, Manuel.
Another car strike. Could you believe it?
Put these kippers back, would you, Basil?
We ought to get butlins to run our car factories.
In the fridge.
You should have been eaten by... When was the 6th?
Oh, that's all right.
It says on the packet, Sybil.
They're all right, Mr. Fawlty.
The 6th?
Let's just to cover them first.
Eggs and sausages, Paul.
Mm-hmm.
On the table, on the table. No. That. Now, put that under him. The cushion, the cushion.
He bit me.
You frightened him.
Okay.
You make sudden movements like that, of course he's going to bite. Don't you have dogs in Calcutta?
Excuse me, but I have an order for eggs and sausages for this table.
Oh, yes. The sausages are for him.
Oh.
What's the matter, Noel?
He bite me.
Cut them up into little pieces. Oh. No, not my eggs, not my eggs, the sausages.
Oh, sorry.
He might pull it too, you see.
Look, if dogs are allowed in the dining room, at least the staff should know how to handle them.
I'll cut them up in the kitchen, Mrs. Chase.
Little pieces.
Get that ready.
He hurt you, Polly. Oh.
Bertha, what are you doing?
Do you know when the six was, Sybil?
Will you just take it upstairs?
They're all right, Mr. Fawlty. Why are we supposed to be
there? Basil, will you just take it up?
What's the matter, Mambo? Oh.
That hairy mosquito just bit its throat.
What?
It's not right in dining room like that.
Well, she pays extra for the dog man, will you see? Basil, it's after eight.
Poisoning is still an offence in this country, you know, Sybil.
Oh, well, do get a move on. We've got a busy day. I've got the laundrymen.
The laundryman? My God, a woman's work is never delegated, is it?
What are you doing, Polly? Just preparing some sausages. Bangers a la bang.
Good morning, breakfast. Breakfast. Here we are. Another car strike marvel, isn't it? Taxpayers pay millions each year to get the money go on strike. It's called socialism. I mean, if they don't like making cars, why don't they get themselves another bloody job designing cathedrals or composing violin concertos? The British Leyland Concerto in four movements, all of them slow, with a four-hour tea break in between. I'll tell you why. Because they're not interested in anything except lounging about in conveyor belts, stuffing themselves with my money. You don't mind if I turn the light off? Well, enjoy your breakfast. I'm sorry, I didn't catch that. Oh, not at all. Thank you for mentioning it. Not a single lucky word. Yeah, that's 5:30 in the morning, so they can lounge around in bed till midday. Did you get so much as a word of thanks? What's that?
Forgot the milk.
Well, don't get talking to him. You never get away.
Would you believe it?
I get him his breakfast, I take it all the way upstairs, I lay it in front of him, hand him his newspaper, I tidy the room, draw the curtains, and guess what he says? I said, guess what he says? Nothing. Your friend, the one in eight, nothing, not a word. Are you listening? Hello, can anybody hear me? Have I ceased to exist? Have I suddenly become invisible? Sybil, can you see me?
No.
Oh, good, well, I go and lie down then. No, I won't. I'll go and hit some guests.
Poor little
Dr. Price's sausages.
What are you, Polly?
He's dead.
Dead? Who?
Number eight.
Lehman? But Basil just took him his breakfast.
He's cold.
Oh, no.
What's the matter with that dog?
He is dead.
Well, he's certainly struggling for life at the moment. Dead dog in the breakfast room, eh? Egon Rooney knock off the star for that.
No, Mr. Lehman, dead.
Well, that would explain a lot.
No, Mr. Really? Paul just said so.
What are you on about? I just took him his kippers. Oh, my God.
Wait. I just put the milk down the tray, but I leave... What are you doing? What are you doing?
I told her the 6 week you get 20 years for this.
What?
The kippers, oh, my God.
Mr. Fawlty, he's been dead for hours. Mr. Fawlty, he's cold. He's been dead for hours. He must have died in his sleep. Mr. Fawlty!
What?
He hasn't touched those kippers. Well, look. Feel him.
What?
Feel him.
He's stone cold.
Yes.
Oh, joy. Oh, thank you. Oh, isn't it wonderful?
I'm so happy. Hooray! So.
Bit stuffy, isn't it? I'll open a window.
Who found the body?
Polly did. I was bringing him up the milk and we'd forgotten it.
You brought the milk with the breakfast?
No, the breakfast was already up.
Well, who brought the breakfast? Who found it?
Oh, I thought of it.
What's that?
That's a bit of it.
A bit of what?
A bit of the breakfast.
You brought him his breakfast?
Yes.
So you told her he was dead?
Yes.
Well, then, why did you bring him... Why did you bring him the milk, then?
Why?
Yes, why?
Well, when he said Mr. Lehman was dead, I thought he said he's still in bed.
Well, he didn't exactly say he was dead, Doctor.
Well, I said he was pretty quiet.
Quiet?
Exactly.
What were you talking to him about, Basil? Car strikes, was it?
Thank you, Sybil.
I don't understand. He's been dead for about 10 hours.
Yes, it's so final, isn't it?
Basil.
Well, wouldn't you say it was final, dear? I'd say it was pretty bloody final.
You mean to tell me you didn't realize this man was dead?
Well, the people don't talk that much anymore. Look, I'm just delivering a tray, right? If the guest isn't singing, oh, what a beautiful morning, I don't immediately think, oh, there's another one snuffed it in the night. Another name in a Fawlty Towers book of remembrance. I mean, this is a hotel, not a Burma railway. Yes, but I mean, he does actually say hotel outside. I mean, perhaps I should be more specific. Hotel for people who have a better than 50% chance of making it through the night. What are you looking at me like that for?
Basil, there's a kipper sticking out of your jacket.
Ah, there it is. I've been looking for that. That's the other one.
We'll be downstairs, Doctor.
Shall I ring the undertaker?
Would you, Polly?
I've been up since 5:30, you know.
He was leaving today. Some people are coming at lunchtime.
Well, we'll put him in another room.
We're full tonight. Oh, do put that away. Get the body into the office till the undertakers come.
Now?
When the doctor's finished.
What are you doing?
Making up his bill.
Who are you going to give it to?
We'll leave it in his wallet. They're bound to look there. Better not charge him for breakfast.
Mr. Timkins? Fawlty Towers here. I'm afraid somebody's died during the night. When could you collect the body? Somebody? Anybody, really?
Good morning, good morning.
Oh, you're very careful this morning, Mr. Fawlty.
Yes, well, one of the guests has just died.
You are wicked.
Manuel. Manuel, we go and get the body. Polly.
Yes, if you can.
Would it be all right to move, please?
Praise the phone, please. I have to call the coroner.
The coroner?
I can't give him his death certificate. I'm not his doctor. I have to report his death to the coroner.
Oh, I see, of course. Do come this way, Doctor.
All clear!
All clear.
Good morning, Manuel.
Good morning. Oh, it's all right. Leave it. No, leave it. It's heavy.
Oh, no, it's quite all right. Put the money
down. No, don't bother. We can manage.
Oh, just don't bother.
No, no, leave it alone.
I know. If I just fold them like
this... Yes, go away. Move, Manuel. Okay. Move. Move.
I'll do it, Miss Kipp. No, it's all right. Ah! He's dead! He's
dead, right.
It's all right, Miss Kipp.
Shut up.
Oh, my God.
Slap her. What? She's hysterical. Slap her.
Murder!
Slap her!
Murder!
Oh, spiffing. Absolutely spiffing. Well done. Two dead, 25 to go. Quick, pull it.
There it is. Oh, sorry, I'm in your way.
That's quite all right, sis.
Oh, is this your room?
Yes.
Oh, it's lovely, isn't it?
Yes.
Did you enjoy your breakfast?
Oh, yes, thank you, yes. Excuse us, do you think we could just go inside and get our...
Not really.
Pardon?
Well, it's been cleaned. Mr. Fawlty's doing it.
But we want to get our things.
Yes, we're going out, you see.
Oh, well, it'll only take a couple of minutes.
Well, I'm sorry, we're a little late. Excuse me.
Excuse me. Mr. Fawlty? Mr. Fawlty?
All clear.
Mr. Fawlty? Mr. and Mrs. White want to come into their room.
Oh.
Hello.
Oh, can we come in?
I was just explaining that you were doing the room.
Yes, probably 5 minutes.
Well, couldn't you do it later?
Pick that ash trap, will you, Manuel, please? The big one. Could we do it later?
When we've got our things. Well, it'll only be a couple of minutes.
Look, Fawlty, we want our things.
Oh, right, yes, thank you so much.
He's locked it.
Oh, well, that's just a precaution.
Have you locked this?
Only slightly.
Will you let us in?
In a minute.
Get the coat.
What's going on? Well, he's a bit of a perfectionist.
Ready?
What's been going on in here?
Well, we tried rearranging the furniture, but it didn't really work. Manuel has your coat.
Oh.
It's all right. He's from Barcelona.
Oh, what a noise!
Oh, it's just my back.
No, that morning.
Oh, yes, that's all.
No, it's coming from the cupboard.
Well, we'll get some oil. Have a nice day.
There's someone in there.
What? Yes, listen.
No.
No.
Good Lord, sir, there is.
Let them out.
Good idea. Right. Well,
go on.
Yes, we're going to. It's the next thing on the list. Oh, if you do get a chance to visit the museum...
Open it right now, will you?
Now? Oh, all right, yes, right. Oh, it's locked. Oh, damn.
Where's the key?
Yes, sir, where is the key? Do you have any idea, Polly Manuel?
I expect we've left it downstairs somewhere.
Yes? Where's the key?
It's in your pocket.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Oh, well then, Manuel. Thank you very much. Thank you. Right, well, we've got it now.
All right,
I will.
Oh, Mr. Tim.
Now, I've warned you about this before. You can hide in your own cupboard, but not in other people's. I'm sorry about this. You can't really blame her. She doesn't have much in her life. She has to make her own entertainment.
She has trouble with her arm. That's why she goes in the cupboard.
Exactly.
Are you feeling better?
Her arm gets stuck there.
It's always happening to her.
He's dead.
This is her husband. She hasn't got over it. Died 30 years ago.
She doesn't mean any arm.
In the cupboard.
No more today. You've had enough. Oh, my God. Look at that. Look.
That's enough.
Anything else we can do for you?
What was so horrible, Mrs. Fawlty? You've no idea.
Oh, I know.
It was pitch black in there, and that thing with its hand.
Oh, I know. Now you have a little rest and try to think of something else.
But anything could have happened.
Well, he was dead, dear.
A man is a man, Mrs. Fawlty.
Oh, I know.
I should speak to him about it.
Speak to him?
To Mr. Fawlty, where his oldest residence.
Well, have a little rest first.
Frightening me like that. I shall speak to him.
Have a word with him in a little while when you're feeling better.
Mm-hmm. I see, yes. Thank you. It's all right, dear. They've got rooms at the Sea View.
Tonight?
Yes.
Well, let's have a look at it.
Yes, and if that's no good, we'll try the one up by the prophylactic emporium.
Okay. Morning, Fawlty.
Oh, hello, Major.
Any sign of the papers?
You've got it, Major.
Have I? Oh, yes, I have. Oh, I say, Fawlty, he doesn't look quite the ticket.
Well, Major, don't say anything to anybody, but he's dead.
Ah. Shot, was he?
No, died in his sleep.
In his sleep? Ah, well, you're off your guard, you see.
Yes.
Oh, Fawlty, I shouldn't let him lie around here, you know.
No, the undertakers are coming to get him.
Ah, because they attract the flies, you see.
Look, I've been waiting in there.
What?
I haven't had any breakfast yet.
Sorry. Come in.
It's only sausages.
Will you please?
Oh, Sorry about the delay, Doctor. Normal service has been resumed as soon as possible. More coffee? Tea? Tea? I'll turn the radio down.
Miss Gibbs.
Oh, no.
Would you believe it?
What did you put in there for?
Well, he wouldn't fit the safe and all the drawers were full. Come on, man.
Wonderful, isn't it? Our guests, they give us trouble even when they're dead. Come on.
Where are you taking him?
Kitchen.
Polly, just a moment.
Done, I'm afraid. Send him down the crematorium.
Oh, you can't keep a dead body in here with us food.
Can't we?
Of course not.
Oh, right. Okay. Sorry, Manuel. Put it in there. In the basket.
Not in here.
What?
Not in the kitchen.
Oh, right. Oh, Sybil?
I'm looking after Miss Tibbs, Basil. How are you feeling, dear?
We'll be 2 minutes. Okay. Sorry about that, Doctor.
Wash your hands first, please.
Oh, right.
And make sure this area is scrubbed before any more food is prepared in here.
Absolutely.
Sausages accepted. You may cook them immediately. I'll take the risk.
Oh, of course. Too sweet.
Leave it.
No, I take it.
Leave it.
No, it's not time, please. No, please.
I'm sitting here.
There's no lunch till 12.
I'm still having breakfast.
It's finished. All gone, breakfast kaput.
I'm having sausages.
He's not allowed.
Put that down. Look, I'm a doctor. I'm a doctor and I want my sausages.
I tell you, he's finished. Bye-bye, please. Bye-bye.
Now, look.
It's finished.
Give those to me. Come on.
No, it's not possible.
Is everything all right? He wants to eat now.
I've been trying to sit down and he keeps moving things from my table.
I'm so sorry.
He doesn't seem to understand that I haven't finished breakfast.
Manuel, let me explain. Ah! You understand? Look, I'll be ready in just a couple of minutes.
There we are, Mr. Ingram's number 8. Top of the stairs on the right. Excuse me not coming up with you. One of our guests has been taken ill.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
In the office.
Excuse me?
Yes?
We have an appointment with Mr. Lehman. Do you know where he is?
Where he is?
Would he be in the dining room?
Might he be in his room?
Let me think. Where is...
We've come to collect him. Well, we're taking him...
Sorry?
We've come to collect him.
Oh, you've come to collect him? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize. Modern dress.
What?
Your dress is very modern. I didn't realize women did it.
Did what?
He's downstairs. No, in the basket.
I beg your pardon.
He's in the basket.
In the basket?
Yes.
Hello.
What's he doing in the basket? Well, not much.
What are you talking about? Well, don't you believe? Look.
Oh, my God, he's gone.
Where is he?
Fresh laundry.
They've taken him.
If you could just hang on a couple of minutes. Sorry to keep you.
It's all right. It's all right. We sorted it out. He's in this one.
The doctor didn't want him in the kitchen, so we put him in the basket.
It's more hygienic.
Yes, you do work here.
Yes.
Well, we'd like to speak to the manager.
Well, I'm the manager. Is there a problem?
Well, he is, really.
No, there seems to be some kind of misunderstanding here. We've come to collect one of your guests, a Mr. Lehman, to take him into town for a meeting.
Meeting? Yes, a meeting.
With our managing director. Oh, I see, Mr. Lehman.
Yes. We thought you said the linen.
Brilliant. Sorry, that's it.
Sorry to keep you.
Hello, my sweet.
What are you doing, though?
Well, it's a bit involved, dear, but these gentlemen thought that they're
coming... No, that's not it. They were coming for Mr. Lehman, and we thought that they were coming to collect the linen.
Mr. Lehman?
Yes, so if you just sort that one out, dear, I'll take the linen upstairs, OK?
I see. Thank you, Basil.
Not at all.
Would you mind coming into the office for a moment?
Another one, Fawlty?
No, no, same one, Major. Sorry, coming like that. Sorry.
They've gone into the trap.
In there.
Sorry. Wrong.
Back to the basket.
I can't live.
Come on.
I'm not too tired.
Is somebody coming?
Mr. Fawlty, I no want to work here anymore.
Open the basket. Open the basket. Now, inside. Look, you!
I quit!
Get out!
I'll strike!
I'm warning you!
I stay here at night!
You see this? You're next!
Really, I'm so sorry. Thank you.
Goodbye. Yes?
Could I get my hat?
Your hat?
Yes. It's just there.
Yes, I'll have it sent on. What? Do you have a card with your address? I'll send it on.
Well, could I just get it?
Well, do you have to have it now?
Well, yes.
Well, supposing you lose it? I mean, it's windy today.
I'd like to have it.
Oh, right. Manuel! He's in the basket. Polly, would you get Manuel out of the basket, please?
Manuel?
Yes, come on, girl, come on. What's the matter?
Well, he isn't in there.
Yes, he is.
He isn't.
He is. Look for him.
Oh, sorry.
You big scum.
See? Manuel, would you get this gentleman his hat, please?
Where? There.
On the rack. Sorry, what colour was it?
Brown. No, that's not it.
No.
Thank you.
Mr. Fawlty, I want a word with you in your office.
Yes, when would it be convenient for you?
I'm 79.
What on earth is going on here?
Oh, sorry about the eyedown. It got a bit caught.
My baby's dying. They poisoned him.
Your baby?
Sybil!
He said he'd called for a vet.
A vet?
Sybil!
I've just cooked these sausages myself and they're off. They should have been eaten by the third.
Ah, there you are, dear. You do look nice. Ladies and gentlemen. Laundry's ready. Ladies and gentlemen, there have been a lot of cock-ups this morning. You all deserve an explanation, and I'm happy to say that my wife will give it to you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
What's going on, old boy?
Basil! Thank you.
Thank you.